boys and girls, and welcome to Bedtime Stories with Miss Elaine. I'm Miss Elaine, and tonight I'm going to read you a book called The Sheep Fairy, When Wishes Have Wings. This is Wendy Woolcoat. Wendy likes eating grass, 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 sleeping, eating grass, eating grass, eating grass, eating grass, eating grass. I guess that's what sheep do, right? They eat and sleep. One day, Wendy was eating grass when a tiny voice said, "Help me! Please help me!" Wonder who's calling. Do you see that something sticking out of a tree? What is that? Take a closer look, boys and girls. It almost looks like a magic wand, doesn't it? Who's stuck in the tree? It was a fairy stuck in a brambly bush. Wendy was a kind sort of sheep, so she ate all of the brambles around the fairy and set her free. "Oh, thank you," said the fairy. "As a special reward for helping me, I'll give you one wish. What would you like?" "Well," said Wendy, thinking hard, "mostly I like eating grass and sleeping." "But you can do both of those things already," said the fairy. "There must be something else you dream about." "Oh, yes," said Wendy. She never told anyone about her secret dream before, but very quietly she told the fairy.
"Speak up," the fairy said. "I can't hear you."
"I dream I'm flying," said Wendy, "flying through the moonlit sky."
Can sheep fly?
No, but this one really wants to. I wonder if his wish will come true. Wendy looked around quickly to see if any of the other sheep had heard her. They all had their heads down, eating grass. Wendy started to eat grass too. It was delicious. "When the moon comes up and the stars come out, your wish will come true," said the fairy, and then she flew off. Wendy was much too busy eating grass to even listen. But when the moon came up and the stars came out, Wendy had a very strange feeling indeed. Is Wendy's wish about to come true? I think so. She felt like she was floating upward. The field was far below. Wendy had grown a beautiful pair of sheep-sized fairy wings on her back, and she flapped them up and down. "Baa!" Wendy bleated to the other sheep, and then she wiggled her legs around as though she were running in the sky. "Baa! Baa! Baa! Look at me! I'm flying!" But the other sheep were fast asleep. Soon, she got the hang of flying. Forward, backward, upward, downward, in a loop-de-loop, in figure eights. Wow, she's getting really good at it, isn't she? Wendy flew over the farmer's house and through the town and out to sea. Flying was wonderful. It was even better than she dreamed it could be. On the way back, Wendy saw a wolf strolling down the lane towards the sheep's field. "Wake up, wake up! There's a wolf coming," Wendy cried. But the sheep kept on sleeping. "Wake up, wake up! There's a wolf coming, and he's coming to get you." But the sheep still didn't wake up, and it was almost too late. The wolf was in the sheep's field. Wendy had to do something. Is she going to be able to save the sheep? Is she going to be able to rescue all of her friends? Let's keep reading to find out. Wendy flew straight at the wolf. "Leave my friends alone," she shouted. And the wolf is running away saying, "Help, Mommy!" The next morning, the sheep in Wendy's field were doing what they did every morning. Eating grass, eating grass, eating grass, eating grass. "I had a really strange dream last night," said Sheep 1.
"Me too,"
said Sheep 2.
"Me 3,"
said Sheep 3. All the other sheep agreed. "Baa, baa, baa." "I dreamed that Wendy could fly."
"That's what I dreamed."
"Me too." "Us too."
But when they went to ask Wendy about it,
she was fast asleep.
The end.
She was fast asleep because she had a long night flying around the world, didn't she?
And there's the magic fairy
who made her wish come true.
The end.
Wonder what it would be like to fly. Did you ever think about that, boys and girls? Would you want to fly? I don't know. Something to think about. Well, let's sing our two lullabies before we say goodnight. I'll put up my twinkle stars, and I invite you to put up your twinkle stars at home, and we'll sing together, Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are.
Great job. If I flip my stick around, you'll see a moon shape. So now we'll sing God Bless the Moon.
I see the moon and the moon sees me. God bless the moon and God bless me.
And God bless you, boys and girls. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time on 5-Minute Bedtime Stories with Missy Lane. Good night.